So I tallied up the total cost of ownership with this truck this morning, and man, did it make me sick.
Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about the running costs of owning a Ram T-Rex, and I know you guys are probably confused as to why the driveway is empty. Well, we actually get a break from press cars for this week, so we don't have any press cars.
The Focus is always in the other driveway,
and then the T-Rex actually have parked on the side of the road right now because I just got it detailed, and these trees just like dump tons of stuff, so I don't have it in this driveway because I don't want it to get dirty, because I'm taking it to a car meet this weekend. But yeah, that's why it's not back here in this driveway. But don't worry, we'll go over to the TRX right away and we'll just talk about the running costs. And so yeah, let's get into the video.
It is an absolute miracle. We have the Focus, look at that, detailed. And we have the TRX also detailed. I mean, again, it's a complete miracle.
First off, it's hot as hell. Second off, 4,980 miles, which I know, that's not a ton of miles, but I can still talk to you guys about the cost that I've had so far on the truck, and then also the cost that I expect to have on the truck considering the powertrain that it has and some other stuff as well that's associated with the truck, like the shocks and all of that. But before I do that, I do have to go run some errands, and don't worry, I'm not gonna take you guys on those errands. Like a lot of YouTubers do that, I won't bore you guys with those. Like, to you guys, it'll look like I literally go from the inside of my truck to my driveway again, which is gonna be kind of weird, but like, I'm going all the way to like one side of the valley and then I'm going to the other side of the valley. If you guys are wondering why, I'm picking up a check to go and drop it off at an orthodontist. Yes, I am finally getting my teeth fixed. Now, I've never really talked about this because it's not really like that big of an issue. So my teeth are actually pretty straight. Like I was genetically gifted, I guess, in that sense where I don't have crazy crooked teeth, but they're crooked enough that it bothers me, and so I think that this is the best thing for me to do, especially considering that I do YouTube now and I'm in front of a camera like all day, every single day pretty much. And so I thought, okay, you know what, I'll do this so that I'll look, I guess, a little bit nicer to you guys that watch the videos. But on top of that, it'll make it so it'll be easier for me to brush my teeth because, again, everything will be lined up. And I'm also sick and tired of being single, and they say that like the first thing that a girl looks at is a guy's smile. So I figure if I get my teeth fixed, which will only take about 12 months, then you know what? Maybe we'll meet the one at that point. But anyways, let's set off. Man, look how cool the TRX looks, just the reflection of the truck. Always a cool sight to see. We officially have the check for an amount that I don't really want to disclose because, well, it's a lot of money, but trust me, it'll be worth it. So we just dropped off the check, and that means next month you guys will start seeing me with Invisalign, and so yeah, it'll kind of look funny with my teeth for a while, but trust me, it'll all be worth it. And that gets me into my first point, because obviously all this driving around gets me into the first cost of ownership with the TRX, and that is, of course, fuel. So right now you can see I'm not averaging very good, about 8.7 miles per gallon, but typically I average about 9 miles per gallon, roughly give or take a few. And so with my average being typically around 9 miles per gallon, I'm not like full throttle all the time, which today I've just been having a little bit of fun. And also, I mean, it's pretty hot outside today, it's 95 degrees. That means that if you drive 10,000 miles a year, then your cost of fuel is gonna be over $4,000 per year. And so that's kind of like the first cost of ownership thing that the TRX is, understand. Fuel economy is horrible. Gas is expensive right now, and if you guys are wondering, I figured at $4 a gallon because you have to fill the TRX with premium. So yeah, that's the first cost, is gas. It'll probably be about $4,000 a year if you drive 10,000 miles. Obviously, if you drive more, it'll be more. So like if you drove 15,000 miles, it's gonna be like $6,000 a year. And then if you drive 20,000 miles, it's gonna be like $8,000 a year for gas. But we are officially back, and now let's get into the next fixed cost on the TRX. So what that is going to be is insurance for the truck. So right now my premium is about $170 a month to insure this truck, and so you do that over the course of a year, and that's about $2,000 a year to have this truck fully insured. Now obviously that's going to vary based on your driving record, the state you live in, and all that kind of, and age as well. Some of you guys might be able to get it cheaper than what I have, some of you will be more expensive, but that's where mine's at. And that's the next fixed cost, is insurance, about $2,000 a year. Now the next thing is going to be tires with this truck. So this has 35s from the factory, and obviously with having a TRX, you're probably going to be driving it pretty crazy, just like I am. I mean, that's what the truck is all about. And so you're gonna go through the tires pretty quick. You guys can see the current wear that I have on the front ones, and then we'll pop over here to the rear, which it looks like these bad boys need to be rotated pretty soon, which that'll be another cost, is with the rotations and oil changes. But in terms of tires, if you stick with 35s, you're probably going to be about $1,600 when you have to get all new shoes. If you go up to 37s, it'll be a little bit more, probably closer to $2,000 roughly. You might be able to find it for less, might be able to find it for more.
But yeah, that's probably what it'll be. In terms of how long these tires will last, it'll depend. So I purposely drive this truck at lower PSI because I like the ride quality, but I understand if you drive it at lower PSI, the tires will wear a little bit quicker. And so I'll probably get like 15,000 miles out of these tires between the off-roading I do and then also the fact that I drive it at lower PSI. And so if I drive, you know, 10 to 15,000 miles a year, that's roughly, right, almost a set of tires every single year. So that could be between $1,600 and $2,000 every single year, depending on if I stick with the 35s or if I go for the 37s. And let me know in the comment section below if you guys want me to go for 37s. I definitely like the look of the 35s, but you know, 37s do look pretty cool on the TRX. Now we got to pop the hood for the next one. Man, I haven't been in this truck for so long, I forgot where the latch was. That is
embarrassing as an owner, but
at least I remember where the middle latch is. Woo, lots of plastic. So obviously this has the 6.2 liter supercharged V8, the Hellcat engine, and
I mentioned this in another video, this thing just goes through oil really quick, and so expect to have to get an oil change about every 3,000 miles. Now, the amount of money it'll cost for you guys to change the oil will obviously vary depending on where you live and the places you can find.
I really don't pay all that much for oil changes.
I just basically get mine done at the Larry H. Miller Dodge Ram in Sandy, and I think it's like literally, it's like less than $100 for like three oil changes, something like that. I don't know, their packages change all the time, but when I purchased the package, I think it was like $90 to $120, somewhere in that range.
And that covered oil changes and then also tire rotations. And so that is pretty much good for a year for me with how many miles I drive. And so I'll probably be about $100 a year with oil changes, roughly, maybe a little bit more, maybe like $120. But just understand every 3,000 miles, oil change. And so again, it'll add another roughly 100, maybe $200, depending on the mileage you drive and all that.
So these next few costs are not going to be necessities, but I definitely recommend them.
So the first one is going to be paint protection film on the front end. I would definitely budget for this if you are going to get a TRX so that you can protect the paint on the front end. And typically to do paint protection film on the front end of a vehicle, so I'm talking, right, the front fender, the whole hood, so all the way up to there on the fender, and then down here with this area, most shops will probably charge you about $1,000 to $2,000, again depending on the shop, depending on the quality, all that kind of stuff. And so just again, take that into account. And then also window tint as well, I always recommend that. That's typically anywhere from like $400 to $500. So just between, you know, doing window tint so it's a comfortable place to be in every single time you're in the truck, and then also with the paint protection film, I would budget, you know, roughly about $2,000 when you do purchase the truck. I should have just kept the hood popped because again, we're gonna be talking about the 6.2 liter V8.
So this engine and power, the whole powertrain in general, so this supercharged 6.2 liter V8 and then the 8-speed automatic transmission are actually very reliable and robust. We see so many Hellcats nowadays that have well over 100,000 miles. The interior, doesn't necessarily hold up the best, but the engine transmission, they seem to hold up very well.
So even if you drive this to higher miles, it'll actually do really good, so you don't have to worry about that part of it too much.
Now the part that you might have to take into consideration has to do with the suspension of the TRX, but you can't really see much there in the front, but we can see the Bilstein active shocks here in the back. So obviously the TRX hasn't been out for long enough for us to really see how long these Bilsteins are going to last, if they're going to be as durable as the Fox shocks on the Raptor. But before filming this video, I talked to a bunch of people that are a lot smarter than me, that know a lot more about shock technology.
And basically what they had to say is the Bilstein system seems to be really robust with how they built it. The only thing going against it is the fact that it's only a 2.5-inch shock. And so the fact that it's a little bit smaller kind of worries them in terms of the long-term reliability.
And if you have to replace shocks like that and it's out of warranty, I mean, you're literally like probably, I mean, I haven't even looked them up, but the Fox shocks are like $5,000 to $10,000 after installation,
depending on the exact shocks you get. And since these are a very similar system, I mean, it could be $5,000 to $10,000 if you do have to replace that system, which, yeah, definitely is eye-wateringly expensive. And so I guess I would just take that into account.
However, obviously, if you're buying this truck, right, at this point, it's gonna have a full warranty on it. And so if anything happened, right, it would be under the excessive wear and tear clause.
Most likely, don't take my word for that. Don't take my word for that. But most likely, and so we don't have to worry about that, but I guess I would take that into account with the TRX, is we just don't know the reliability of the shocks so far.
Now let's cap things off by going over modifications, right? This is the fun stuff you could do with the truck from a cost perspective. So there's bumpers now out for the truck. There's also an exhaust system. You guys can see I've got the Mopar lights, all that kind of stuff. There's tons of fun stuff you can do with the truck. And modifications happen to be pretty expensive for the TRX. So most bumpers I've seen out there just for front bumpers, they're typically around that like over $2,000 price range. Rear bumpers are in the mid-teens in terms of price. And then in terms of an exhaust system, most exhaust systems I've seen are about $2,000. And then those Mopar lights, after installation, they're typically about $800 for just two lights. So if you do all four lights, you're about $1,600. So yeah, modifications can be pretty pricey. If you guys are running on a full wrap with a truck like this, most places are gonna charge you anywhere from $4,000 to $6,000. So again, pretty expensive on the modification side. And yeah, I mean, it's fun stuff, but obviously that doesn't have to do with the running costs. I thought I'd just mention it because yeah, but let's get into the total now. So if we tally everything up for the fixed costs of owning a TRX for a year, and I'm going to assume that you're gonna drive this truck about 15,000 miles a year. Again, I'm assuming that your insurance rate's gonna be roughly the same as mine. And then the cost of gas is going to be about $4 a gallon, right? It could go up, it could go down. We don't know, but if we take all that into assumption, and also you're gonna have tons of fun with the truck like what I'm doing right now, so you're probably gonna go through a set of tires every 15,000 miles, then your yearly running cost is going to be a little bit over $10,000 to own the truck.
Which, yes, I understand that is very expensive, but also the truck is very expensive. So if you can afford the truck, you can afford the running costs. But yeah, that's pretty much everything tallied up.
And then if you do plan on modifying the truck, so if you wanna do a similar build to what I'm doing on my TRX, where I've done a full wrap on the truck, I've added the Mopar lights, I have two more that I'm gonna be adding, and then I'm doing the front and rear bumpers from ADD, and then also an exhaust system that is coming from AWE.
If you guys are wanting to like basically do the exact same build that I have with my truck, then I would set aside about $12,000 roughly.
Yeah, pretty expensive. So yeah, if you plan on decking out your truck like what I've done, and then also just having the basic running costs and having tons of fun with your truck, then expect in the first year to spend about $20,000. And that's assuming that you don't break anything that's not covered under warranty. Again, most of the stuff will be covered under warranty, right? Because it's the first year that the truck's been out. But yeah, if you break something and it's not covered under warranty, then that'll obviously add to that expense. But yeah, that's pretty crazy. $20,000 for the first year, and then after that, you're probably about $10,000 a year. It's pretty expensive to drive around a vehicle.
Well, hopefully that was helpful for you guys if you are looking into purchasing a Ram TRX. And overall, absolutely love this truck. Obviously, the cost is definitely worth it for me because, well, I still own the truck and I do not plan on getting rid of it whatsoever. But yeah, if you're stopping for the first time, I really appreciate it if you subscribe, comment down below what you think. And then if you guys want me to do more TRX content like this, then just let me know and I'll be more than happy to do that once I get free time, which I don't really have a whole lot of free time except for today. So that's why I made this video. But yeah, I'll see you guys.